Hello, everybody, and welcome to the first ever episode of DCA Wildcats. This is Josh Stetson here. I'm alongside Rick Diamond, and we are starting off strong tonight with the Women's Championship Tournament first round match as Allison Simone will take on Angel Sanchez. And Allison Simone tonight is making her debut here in DCA.
That's right, and we are live from the DC Arena in Nashville, Tennessee. And you know what? It wouldn't be that bad, but I just had to make the flight from Philly over here, and I'm still kind of stinky from that crap city.
Yeah, I remember seeing you. Y'all look like y'all were having fun here, but you know what? We're here tonight in Nashville, and I just can't wait to see you this night. Purely filled with women's action, the best that DCA has to offer, no doubt, in the women's division. As this young lady will make her debut tonight against definitely one of my favorite women on this roster, Angel Sanchez.
Well, yeah, you know what? I could have a favorite in this match if they both weren't whores.
Oh my God. Okay, hang on now. What's your problem with these two women, okay? These two, or at least as far as I know, Angel Sanchez has put more dedication into this company than most of the men.
One sentence can summarize my feelings for these two women. I do not support prostitution.
Why do you think they're prostitutes? You know nothing about these women.
Well, just look at them.
They're wearing wrestling gear.
Very revealing wrestling gear. It's all in how you look at it. This match is now underway here. Josh, and what do you think about these two women? I'm sharing my feelings. How do you feel about them?
Well, honestly, I've seen Angel Sanchez compete many times here in DCA, and I'm really looking forward to see this newcomer, Allison Simone, making her debut. And from what I've heard, she's wrestled all around the world in many different companies. She's a part of the wrestling family, I believe, second or third generation. And it's great to see what she can do here in the DCA arena. Just a few blocks away from the Bridgestone Arena.
That's right, but just to let you know, though, Angel hasn't had a title match since episode 3 of Takedown, so it kind of shows why I don't like her just from that. She just plain sucks, Josh, in more ways than one, I might add, because why did the owner not give her a title shot? It's been over a year, Josh. How did she slip through the cracks if she's really as good as you say she is?
Well, I mean, if you go back to some of the older CTVs and saw, especially the Gateway to Heaven one, you saw that this woman put herself and the other woman that was in the match through hell. You should know that she deserves to be in the title contendership, and she's definitely been very impressive so far, and so has this newcomer, Allison Simone.
Well, you know what? She's going to have to do a lot more than what she's doing right now to impress me.
Oh, man, elbow by Allison Simone. Now Allison Simone is full control over Angel Sanchez going for the cover. But, oh, kick out, early kick out, my bad. I think that was like a one count, maybe earlier.
You know what, look at that hurricane runner. See, that was nice, though.
Holy. Nice athleticism shown by Angel Sanchez.
Well, now the kicks going to Simone there. And now got Angel Sanchez in the corner here, brutalizing her.
This match is just been back and forth so far, and look out!
This power bomb!
Power bomb! Impressive agility shown by Angel Sanchez catching her in midair. Looks like from what I've seen so far, Allison Simone has been so far more on the powerhouse side of this match, while Angel Sanchez has more of the high-flying techniques. Oh, nice snap suplex by Simone there. And now Simone going up top. What is this? Oh, man!
Going for the cover now. It could be over, but it's not quite yet. You know, these two women are showing more resiliency and strength, power, than I thought they would. But, you know, I still don't know. I'm not convinced quite yet, Josh.
And now she's just brutalizing her opponent. Now what's she got?
Take her up here for a fisherman suplex. Just the two count, though. And now, oh, look at that kick to the head, though.
Allison Simone so far has been very impressive. Oh, hang on now.
See, now that's what I like. That's what I like to see right there. Doing whatever you've got to do to get the gold. And you know what? If she wrestles like that more often, she would have already had gold around her waist as she goes for the cover here.
Well, we're definitely trying to make her impact. Just remember, the winner of this tournament will get a title shot at the next CPV, 0 Hour. They'll face the new DCA Women's Champion, Morgan Reincroft.
But with that being said, you know, great maneuvers like that from Angel Sanchez. I don't know how much more she's got left, but I still don't think any of the women in this tournament could compete with Morgan. One of the women in this division that I actually
love, man.
For obvious reasons.
Yeah, we all know that you have a little crush on Morgan Reincroft.
Well, you know what? Let's not point out the obvious here, Josh. Let's call the action.
Yeah,
as Allison Simone,
Angel Simone
up top.
I'm like, yeah, Simone up top, and she took her down. And let me correct myself here. It turns out that the finals of the tournament will be held at 0 Hour, and then they'll get a title shot against Reincroft in the future. My mistake. And now,
hang on now.
Simone falling to the outside. And what's Angel Sanchez got planned here? Oh, no, she faked her out.
Angel coming back, though. Corkscrew dive. And now Angel gonna pander to the fans here.
I wouldn't exactly say that. I'd say that she's letting some energy go, and now she's doing it again. Oh, man! Corkscrew DDT on the outside.
I think they need to back up. These Hicks in Nashville might get a little too crazy.
You don't like anyone, do you? You don't like any town that we go to.
No, no. You're wrong there, because I love myself.
Oh, yeah. Okay, that's nice to know that you love somebody.
And you can't forget Madison Lockhart.
Constantly going after Simone, not giving her a second to breathe. And now, Angel Sanchez up top again!
Goes for the cover here, she could have it! But no, Allison is able to kick out of that one. What a move that was from the top rope, though, Josh.
Constant attacks, not giving her a second to breathe, going up to the top again. What she got planned here?
Waking her up here, waiting to hit something. Missile drop kick.
Hang on now.
Back to the top rope and an arm drag.
This right here. This right here, going for the cover. No, but a kick out too. See, I like this. This right here is Angel Sanchez using her high-flying ability to her advantage. She's doing everything she can to take out of this and move on to become a future women's champion in this company. But she was a little off target there, and now Allison Simone taking advantage.
Right, Allison Simone was able to move out of the way there, and now she may be getting a little too ahead of herself here. I don't know if this is smart with
now.
Somebody.
Oh, look at that. And Angel Sanchez is laid out. This could be a finish, but no, a late kick at it too.
These women are actually impressing me tonight. And honestly, I didn't really expect that from what I heard. She flipped her back over.
And she flipped her over. Look at this.
She kicks out at 2.5. But no, as I was saying, you know, I kind of thought that I might be impressed from what these fans told me about how great the women's division here in DCA. And when I came here, you know, I kind of expected this this contest to be great tonight, but I wasn't quite sure about these two women. But you know what? They have shown me something here tonight. And you know what I say? You never can trust a man from Nashville.
As Allison Simone heads toward her, but no, she lifts her up in a flapjack. You know, I've been here all week. I was here for the last... Actually, wait. This could, as we go for a roll-up, but no. I was here for the most recent WCWCPV Blood Ties. As we were just here a week before Sunday. Getting ready to
how
go.
How great it was. I was in attendance.
That's right. As now, Angel Sanchez could be calling for the end here.
Could be. Turns around here looking for something.
But no, looks like she's thinking twice, trying to... Oh, hang on, look out.
Look at this roll-up here from Allison Simone.
No, Sanchez flips it. You know, it kind of looks like Sanchez was going for the... I don't exactly know how you pronounce the first word, but the heartbreak. There's a J in it. It's T-R-J. I don't really pronounce those types of words. As now, Allison Simone calling up Angel Sanchez. She has her up. Oh, man.
One, two, and it's not enough. I think you were looking for the Tijuana heartbreak there, Josh.
Thank you. As now, Angel Sanchez going for the roll. These women, I have to admit, they're being incredibly resilient. As Allison Simone does another moonlight drive on the Sanchez. And now Simone could be looking to finish it.
Well, if she can survive this, I'm officially a fan.
Sanchez start coming. And now.
Look at that. Kick right to the back of the head.
Right there. That right there is the high-flying athletic ability shown by Angel Sanchez. Oh, there we go again.
Man. Hey, it's gotta be over, Josh, here. It's over. Oh, what?
And now, no. Moonlight drive.
And it's gonna be... And I don't know how these two women are surviving here, Josh. I don't know.
It's been an amazing match, and again... Oh my God, this match has just been, and she could be calling for the end here. She could be going for the Tijuana heartbreak.
That's right, and I think she is.
But no. And now, Allison Simone. Look out.
Oh, man.
Allison Simone out of nowhere.
And two, three.
Oh, man.
Allison Simone will officially move on into the second round of the DCA Women's Championship Tournament tonight. And she proved me wrong, but I'm still standing by what I said about Angel Sanchez.
That's right, but that's nowhere near it. We still got more women's action coming up right here on DCA Wildcats 1. All right, everybody, we are back for more DCA Wildcats. If you're just now joining us, this is Josh Jetson here alongside my commentary partner, Rick Diamond, and we are here in the DCA Arena in Nashville, Tennessee for the first ever episode of DCA Wildcats, as every match tonight will be a Women's Championship Tournament first round match. And here comes Madison Lockhart.
This is one of my favorites right here, Josh, and I can't even explain why. Just something about Madison Lockhart just captivates my attention. You know what? This is a rugged female, and you know what? She can get it done in the ring, and that's the bottom line. You know it, I know it, and all these Nashville fans tonight know it. That's why she's in this tournament, because even the owner knows it.
Now, coming out right now, one of the mainstays of Allure Wrestling, we haven't really seen her in DCA since Redemption, when she caught Amber Stevens in a match against Delilah, who is also going to be competing in the tournament tonight. And right now, she does not look like a happy woman.
Well, you know what, she doesn't, and I do like Ophelia Winter's style. It's just that I really cannot go against Madison Lockhart. I just can't bring myself to do it. But if Ophelia Winters does win tonight, does pull it out, I can't say I'll be disappointed. She is one of the best here in DCA.
We haven't really seen much of her since Redemption, but if she can pull off the victory tonight, she'll be one step closer to being on top of the women's division. That's pretty much what every woman on this show wants to do. She wants to be on top. She wants to be the one person that people who come to the show, when they go home, they want people to be talking about her. That's what every person wants. And that's right, and that's where these two women are going to be competing for right now, to etch their name in DCA history.
And I think Madison Lockhart is going to have her name etched in DCA history here tonight, live from Nashville. But again,
look out. Ophelia Winter's coming in hard already, just firing shots left and right.
Well, that's right, and she can fire shots left and right all she wants to, but even if she gets through Madison Lockhart tonight, you still have to go through Morgan Reincroft, and who could do that? I mean, let's be honest, as good as Madison Lockhart is, even if she does pull it out tonight, she does pull it out in the second round, and she goes all the way. I don't think anyone can beat Morgan Reincroft.
I actually kind of gotta agree with you there. Morgan Reincroft is definitely very dominant. We gotta focus more on this match. Running into the steel sets again. And Ophelia Winters has been the top dog in this match the entire time, just throwing Madison Lockhart around the arena like a lap dog.
Well, you know what? I think the referee needs to step in and do something about this.
I mean, Ophelia Winters, she seems more focused than anyone I've ever seen in a wrestling ring so far. Referee calling up, almost at an 8 count. Referee honestly does need to get some control. She has to be really careful, because if she's too many outside objects, she could get herself disqualified. And now, Ophelia Winters! Oh, man!
Hit that pump handle slam there and goes for the cover. And this ref now going to count the pin, and it's only a 2.5, but you know what? I think the ref needs to be replaced tonight, because she hasn't done a very good job so far controlling Ophelia Winters here.
Well, to be honest, would you want to try to control her? Oh, big boot!
You know what? Goes for the cover here. 2-0! Not enough to put away Madison Lockhart, but who really thought it would be enough, right? See, you know what? I'm going to say this, and I'm going to say this now. If I was controlling things in that ring, they would always listen to Rick Diamond, and you better believe that.
You know, I mean, I got to be honest, Rick. I mean, the new referee in DCA for the Wildcats division, her name is Jennifer Hawkins, and honestly, she's actually not doing a bad job, at least in my mind. Okay, she made sure they got back in the ring, and at least not yet, she is keeping her from doing something that she may regret. And right now, Madison needs to do something to get back in this match. This entire match has been Winters.
Well, you know why it's been winners? Because the jaded referee let her go outside and use the steel steps to her advantage.
Did you see that powerbomb? She landed on the back of her neck.
She landed on the back of her neck. Yes, she did. Now, Ophelia Winter's not even going for the cover, picking her up.
Okay, Madison may need a... If she can't get back in this match, then there is no hope for her. And just constant boxing punches as Madison Lockhart gets her way back into the match, it looks like. Madison,
about time.
Give up. Oh. This could be it, but
and
no,
this referee
Madison
is actually going to count after she's already basically left.
Oh, man.
Okay.
Elbow to that cheek, and this may be it, but no, Madison Lockhart still has some fight in her. Madison Lockhart getting her second.
Yeah, now here we go. This is a match. This is a fair match. You know, we don't need to be going outside using steel steps, all this stuff.
I don't understand how she's still up after the beating she's taken. She is showing no signs of quit after running into two different steel steps in the barricade, taking all that punishment. She is still fighting back against Olivia Winters.
The biased referee, let her go outside and use all that stuff in a match that is not a no disqualification match. You're right. I am surprised Madison Lockhart's still in it.
And now
that just proves my point that she's the best.
Now.
Oh, look at that.
Madison
spinning
Lockhart
elbow there.
Doing everything she can to keep Ophelia Winters down. And now she's going up top. What is she calling for? What is this?
You're waiting for her to get up.
No, I don't like that fall that she took.
Crash and burn, Josh, is all I have to say on that one.
Hang on there, rolling up.
Off the ropes, though, and Ophelia Winters back in control.
Hang on now, what's she calling for? Spinning her
around.
Turns
her around here. What are these two women doing here? They're feeling out each other, man. Kick to the back of the head.
Yeah. Oh, man, taking her down. Madison Lockhart is not going to give up. She's not going to go down without a fight. And another side.
Now, punishing Ophelia Winters.
She's teaching Ophelia Winters that she's more of a second game player. She's going to call for the end here. She has her up in the fireman's carry, but no, she gets out. And a CDT. Looked like Madison was going for her finishing maneuver, the lockdown. But no, Ophelia Winters saw coming in another sidewall slam of her own.
Ophelia Winters calling for the end again here.
When she has her up, fireman's carry. Oh, man.
What a maneuver that was, Josh. And you know what? It would be over if she'd go for the cover, I think.
She's already.
There's no way Madison Lockhart can withstand this kind of punishment.
You don't need to do another one. Oh, man. She was already down for the count. That wasn't called for.
Wasn't called for at all, but that's the style of Ophelia Winters getting the big win here tonight.
I mean,
at DCA Wildcats.
Man, that was just a message sent to the entire roster.
It certainly was. She was not out for a victory tonight. As you said, she was out to send a message, and she did just that.
No, I mean, Rick, looks like there's some medical personnel coming out to attend Madison.
Well, she definitely needs it after that beating. I'm very disappointed in her.
She is hurt.
It's been Hello, ladies and gentlemen. This is D Wall, the founder of the Destiny Championship Alliance, and I'd like to take this opportunity to warn you of a little production error in the next matchup. The next match between Akira Yukimura and Jessica Lewis had an issue with commentary that I could not resolve post-edit. Some of their words are jumbled on top of one another, and sometimes the audio cuts out in commentary, and you're unable to understand or hear what they're saying. So I'd just like to take this opportunity to, one, apologize for the technical difficulties, and number two, promise you that it will not happen again in the next episode, and I hope you guys can still enjoy the in-ring action regardless. Thank you for your time, and enjoy the rest of DCA Wildcats.
We are back here in the DCA Arena in Nashville as we have another Wildcats match for you here tonight in the first round of the Wildcats tournament. Jessica Lewis coming out here. Jessica Lewis coming down to the ring. I don't know about this woman here. I haven't seen very much of her in DCA so far. What do you think, Josh?
Jessica Lewis, I gotta be kind of on the fence with you too. I've not seen much of her, but from what I know, she is one of those fun-loving, she loves to go high risk, and most of the time for her, it ends on right. So I would not be surprised if she comes out as a victor tonight, taking on Akira Yukimura, I believe.
These fans just don't know about Jessica Lewis. They just don't know what to think about her, and I'm with them. I just don't know about her. I have that feeling that she might have a dark side to her, but then, you know, she goes off and does something good for all the people. I don't know what to think about this woman, but I'm going to tell you what, she does have the power to get it done tonight.
The reason Jessica decides she wants to make a change in her career, and as we'll probably see in this match, she's a bit more aggressive than she used to be. We're coming to the ring now, Akira Yukimura. Akira has competed in DCA for quite some time now. I believe she was also in the DCA Gateway to Heaven Women's Ladder Match. You see a lot of her seeing that one.
Let me tell you what, Josh. I will admit, Akira reminds me a lot of my favorite tag team here in DCA, and that is the Rising Suns. And considering that she's Takeru's younger sister, that is well deserved.
That is true. The Rising Suns, probably the fastest rising tag team in this division, in this company, I meant to say, my bad. As Jessica Lewis takes down Akira Yukimura, but now Akira's fighting back, has Jessica Lewis on the apron. Lewis sees it coming, a big fist to the face.
Yeah, big punch to the face there. Now, elbow, look at that back elbow to the face from Akira.
Now Akira, oh man, spinning heel kick, and another one.
Another one for good measure there. It looks like Akira is taking this match into her own hands early, having things her way.
She ducked under twice, but no! She saw it coming, and now Akira's on the wrong side of a beatdown by Jessica Lewis as Jessica bounces her off the rope. And now Jessica, she ducks under her again. And no,
let me
Jessica,
tell you, that's
I
somewhere
mean,
you don't
want to
be.
Akira is now once again under control. She saw her coming, and she delivered that huge hurricane rana.
Into the corner here, Jessica Lewis into the corner, and no, moves out of the way. Oh, look at that, just slams her on the floor, going for the cover now, could have it here, two and no, not enough to put away Akira.
Jessica Lewis is once again in control with the headlock. Now, what is this? Hang on now.
Now looking for that elbow to the face once more. Jessica Lewis and Akira as well are really trying to take each other out early. They do not want to be here long, it seems. They want to get out of Nashville as much as possible. I can't say as fast as possible. I can't say that I blame them.
I mean, when you're in this type of tournament, you want to get to these matches early so that way you don't risk getting an injury. As Akira jumps on top of her and looks like she went for a quick pin there. As again, another heel kick to the skull. And now Akira is in full control over Jessica Lewis. Kick to the gut. DDT.
What a vicious DDT that was. And now looking for it. No.
Akira has her up on the apron now. What does she have planned here? Oh no, Jessica Lewis. Face buster, and her feet were on the top rope. That would do so much damage.
You're right. It could do all the damage here. But she does kick out. I was about to say that it could be over for Jessica Lewis there.
Akira bouncing up, using the ropes for leverage as she does a cross body from the apron. And now Akira Lewis in full control.
Akira has impressed me so much in this match. You know, I'm riding after that DDT as well. I'm just going to go ahead and call her the Rising Daughter here tonight.
That might have been a little too soon now. Jessica Lewis rolls out the ring, and now she has her up. Spinning DDT! Oh, man. And just remember that the winner of this match will face Allison Simone in the second round for the women's title tournament.
That should be a good match no matter who wins this one.
Now she's beating on the back of Akira. Remember, Akira's back is hurt too much and she can't do those high-flying moves that she loves to do.
Well, and that's what Jessica Lewis needs to do. She needs to keep Akira grounded. Here, look at that neck burner. That's a way to do it right there, Josh. Kicks out at 2.5, though.
Tell you what, Jessica Lewis has been impressing me here in that. She's definitely using those more vicious tactics that she said she likes to do with slaps to the chest. You see Akira's chest turning a bright red as again she aims to the back and the back of her skull too.
Well, it seems like Jessica Lewis is just picking apart Akira in this one, just taking her out little by little until she just can't fight anymore. Now taking her to the outside.
And Jessica Lewis just took out. I mean, I don't like that fall that Akira took. I mean, she just fell, and it looks like her back of her head landed on the outside. Jessica Lewis could be looking to come in and finish this.
She definitely looks disoriented here, Josh, as she's going to shoot the half and go for the cover. Could be it. Oh, I thought she was done there.
Yeah, Kira may not know where she is. She may not know where she is. As again, aiming for the back of the head.
I think it was pure instinct, Josh, that she kicked out of that one. I think you're right. I don't think she does know where she is.
I'm beginning to think that half the moves that she does is instinct. Just the basic instinct that she was taught by her older brother, one half of the Rising Sun, as she goes for a Hurricane Rana using the rope for a little bit of more.
Spinning elbow there to take out Jessica Lewis after she used the ropes as leverage for that Hurricane Rana. And look at that chicken wing. I bet she learned that from her brother as well. And that's a real advantage that Akira has here. She was able to learn from her brother and one half of the Rising Suns.
Right, and now Akira Yukimura trying to get back into that high flying feel that she loves to do as she delivers a huge elbow and a heel kick, taking down Jessica Lewis. And hang on now. Yuki Moore just delivered a huge bulldog onto Jessica Lewis, and she could be calling for the end here.
Not even going to go for the cover, though, but Jessica Lewis is. And now flips her over. And now, okay. Akira able to kick out. I didn't know what was going on there for a second. They had me disoriented, and I'm not even in the match.
Jessica Lewis now stuck on the top rope, and Akira, she falls out again. This time she looks like she's laying on her back. She looks a little disoriented again. She might want to get that checked out after the match, because if she keeps this up, she could get a serious injury.
Hey, Ruby, I think that one of them just needs to lay down and call his splits here. It's not worth an injury.
That's right.
She goes for the cover. Goes for the cover. Not enough to put away Jessica Lewis. No matter what Akira has done here, it just has not been enough.
You could say the same thing for Jessica Lewis, as she's trying to put away Akira, but she cannot do it, as she lives in a huge DDT. And now Jessica Lewis could be calling for the end. Well, look out.
Could be. Rolls over.
Oh, man.
Look at the kick right to the chest.
What is this?
Yes. What is this?
Run now. Ankle breaker. The lucky seven.
Like, oh no, she got the rope to leverage.
This could be it. No, even with... That made it harder to kick out, as she is constantly aiming for the skull. Now Jessica Lewis again trying to kick at the back of the head. Yeah, Akira looks disoriented, and she doesn't look like she knows where she is right now.
That's right, and Jessica Lewis taking full advantage of that. She's being a ultimate opportunist here.
Akira, she has no idea what's going on. Again, she's trying to take you at the back of the head. That's where all your thoughts come in. That's where all the strategies people think about going. So if she injures him, hey, we may not see a kick at this. Athleticism on display by Akira. That movie's probably taught to her by her older brother, like I said, one half of the Rising Sun.
Maybe over here. Shooting star, standing, no, not enough to put away Jessica.
Now, Kira, she's
just a little disoriented.
Jessica sees it coming. This match is just in back and forth. No idea who could win. It's the only thing that is really leading to something is that Akira is looking pretty sorry. Now Jessica Lewis goes for the roll up.
Still not enough. This match has been incredible tonight, Josh.
That's right. And Akira goes for the roll up herself.
Good feet. Oh,
I wonder if this match has to have a winner eventually. Something just has to get to these ladies. Is it Jessica Lewis jumps on the rope?
I've never seen
a leg drop in. That right there was the deal breaker by Jessica Lewis. And now what's this? Uh-oh, look out. The 39th Street Slam. And that's it. Akira is out.
Okay, count to 100, Josh. That's gonna be all over for Akira. Her dreams have been by the one and only Jessica Lewis tonight.
She might need to go to the infirmary and make sure that she didn't get concussion. Alright, but we're not done yet. We still have the main event coming up. The main event will be Delia versus Lacey Adams right here on DCA Wildcats.
Jessica Lewis's hand raised in victory tonight.
Everybody, we are back here at DCA Wildcats, and it is time for the main event.
That's right, it is time for the main event, Josh, but you know what? That last match even felt like the main event. It was just an incredible match. Both women gave it all they had, but you know what? For Akira, it just wasn't enough. But will Lacey Adams be able to give enough tonight? Will she be able to move on to the second round?
A little bit of note for Lacey Adams that she's small, chaotic, and a bit different, which is kind of crazy, and she'll bite your face off if you look at her wrong. Part of a small screamo band called Blood Veil. Lacey Adams takes her love for the stage and brings it into her other love, professional wrestling.
Hold on, I don't mean to cut you off, Josh, but there's one small problem with that.
What would that
Nobody
be?
Nobody cares. And now,
Joe Hyatt
coming out here. Yeah, it does, because I'm the voice of the people. And Joe Hyatt coming out here, here's a real Wildcat.
Right.
Oh, gosh, a real wild cat to the ground in the ring with Del Haya. The winner of this match, a.k.a. Del Haya, will face Ophelia Winters in the next round. And as for Del Haya, she is known as the hardcore messiah for a reason. Will we see some of that? Will we see that side of her tonight? I hope so. I hope so. You know why? Because I really want, all I want right now is for Lacey Adams to suffer and her dreams to be broken tonight.
Well, okay, I'm going to have to cut you off there because a part of me agrees with what you said, is that Del Haya, she brings that fiery red-hot action to the ring, but, you know, Lacey Adams, she's very talented in the ring. She brings a different style of wrestling. She brings that chaotic wrestling that many of our fans love to see. You know, that's interesting, though, what you said, considering this question. What happens if Del Haya wins and Del Haya faces her best friend, Ophelia, in the next round?
You know what I think happens, Josh?
What?
You know what I think happens? I think then we see the greatest match in DCA history. That's what I think happened. But
Matt, if you...
we see Lacey Adams go through, we see the biggest fluke in DCA history. So either way, somebody's making history tonight.
Oh my god. Okay, the biggest fluke. So you think if Lacey Adams wins, it'll automatically be a fluke, okay? You don't know how it'll happen, but you just assume that if she wins, it'll be a fluke.
Right.
What makes you so certain about that?
Because Lacey Adams is not on Delhi's level. I mean, first off, this is our first ever match in DCA. And she is facing the hardcore... No. Shut up, Josh. Shut up. I am talking, and you do not speak when I am speaking. Do you understand? You do not talk to a legend that way. Now, as I was saying... the hardcore messiah is who she is facing tonight, and she will come out the victor. Do you understand me?
I think so. Okay. Anyways, now Lacey Adams has full control over Delhi, kicking her in the gut while she's stuck on the ropes, and now...
Josh, I'm going to stop you there, because I heard your little snickering there. When I lashed out at you, were you laughing at me?
No, not at all.
Do you take this as a joke? Okay, you know what? I'm gonna laugh now. I'm gonna laugh with you, because do not make me jump across this commentary table and sew your mouth shut, rookie.
Okay, hang on, man. You call me a rookie. I'm pretty certain I've been studying these and commentating this business longer than you have.
Is that back talk I hear?
You're damn right.
Oh, so we're getting tough now. Well, you know who else is tough? Delhaya. And she is going to win. Back to this match anyway. Why don't you learn to do your job instead of worrying so much about me? Delhi is going to win tonight. Why? Because simply, she is the hardcore messiah.
Now, Delhi going for the cover. Now, this could be good. Going for the cover. No, a kick out, too. By Lacey Adams. Oh, man, huge fit.
She might as well just give up now, Josh, because if she doesn't, she's just going to suffer more. You know, and that's okay with me. Believe me, that's fine. But I would think that for her sake, she would want to just quit now.
I mean, she has done a decent job, but right now, Delhi is in full control as she goes for another pin attempt. As Lacey Adams still kicked at it, too.
Josh, Lacey, I think you're just... plain stupid if you think that if Lacey Adams has any way of coming out here the winner tonight, when Delhi is already in a bad mood considering how she lost it all or nothing against Amber Stevens, and considering that she passed out, she didn't tap out, she didn't get in.
Hey, say that again. What happened? She lost. Okay,
No. Not in my book. She passed out. Did she tap out?
No.
Did she get pinned?
She went through so much pain
that she
was unable to continue the match. That right there, she lost. It's a key word.
Listen. How do you know that she didn't have an underlying medical condition that caused her to faint? How do you know it was because of the pain?
Because they have to clear with medical staff and make sure that they have no medical issues to make sure that they can actually compete. Okay?
Well, she didn't lose in my book, but now you're telling me doctors don't make mistakes?
Okay. Okay, what I know... behind this other league that was just down the block a few nights ago, as we saw some pretty brutal matches in that, as now Oh no. Del Hyatt boot to the ground. Oh man.
There's your eventual winner right there. It's only a matter of time, maybe a second away, but for some reason, Lacey Adams feels the need to continue.
You know, I'm actually willing to make a bet with you that Lacey Adams is going to come out on top.
Well, what would that bet be?
Hit me with your best shot.
Hit you with my best shot. Boy, if I hit you with my best shot, you're not getting back up, and I'll have to finish the show by myself, so I think you better watch it.
Okay, anyways, let's try to focus more on the match, as now Lacey goes for a drive-by kick on the Dale Hyatt, and now Lacey Adams goes up top. She's telling
her... I want to know how Lacey is still in this thing.
Oh, man, that was a nasty fall.
This isn't now, right.
Scroll, but Lacey Adams sees it coming and a sidestep.
This is not right, Josh. This is not. Get her down from there, ref. Get her down from there. She has no business being on the top rope.
It's a wrestling match. You're allowed to be on the turnbuckle.
She cheated.
She cheated. How did she cheat?
She climbed the top rope. You're not supposed to be in the ropes.
Okay.
I need to get you a rule book here. DCA rule book.
Being on the turn, do you want me to actually get the DCA handbook?
Goes back to this awful ref here tonight. Yeah, you're supposed to count when they go to the top rope. She's letting them run wild tonight.
You're allowed to go on the top rope, okay? That's inside the ring.
Well, nonetheless, this match is over.
It's over? This could be over really soon at this point, because both these women have taken a ton of abuse.
I haven't seen Del Hyatt take any abuse.
Are you kidding me?
I'm not.
I'm going for another my kick on a Del Hyatt.
And she kicked. She didn't get his first time. Back. 1, 2, and kick out. Thank you. Thank you, like I said.
Let's call it the zombie skull crusher. And again, flying through the air on a Del Hyatt.
This could really end up being bad, couldn't it?
That's right. She throws her into the steel steps. No, she didn't really connect to it, but it looks like her ankle tripped onto it. Now these two
get
are
up,
fighting
Jill! Fight back!
Oh, man. Onto our announce table. You know, this, this could be over soon. And you know what? When you do, you're going to be eating your own words.
Well, not because this referee is not doing her job.
She's counting them.
You know what? The only person who should be allowed to use weapons in this match, such as the barricade and the announce table, is Del Hyatt. And she better get back in the ring right now. The referee is almost at 9. And, no. Get in the ring. Okay. This match has resulted in a 10 count.
Actually, this is DCA.
See how stupid this
ref
is? I've been telling you all night long.
It's a 20 count.
Well, that's my bad.
Don't worry.
I'm sorry.
I kind of had the same. You know, you remind me of this one guy I commentate with a lot. You know, he's really stubborn. He's really, you know, he gets offense easily. He's really biased. He's just like you. I got to introduce you to one day. Those two hit it off as Del Hyatt goes for the cover, but no, kick in at 2.
Yeah, well, I don't think that's going to be necessary. I don't need to beat anybody. I don't like anybody but me. And I'm one of a kind.
You and Nathan hit it off.
But no
as
thanks,
Del
Rookie.
Could be... Rookie, I've been in this business longer than you, thank you. Okay? As Del Hyatt... No! Lacey Adams gets out of it. But no! Del Hyatt sees it coming in reverse neckbreaker.
And now Del Hyatt in full control.
Never mind. As no! Lacey Adams! Oh man, Lacey Adams could be calling for a finishing maneuver.
No, no, no.
Yes.
No,
yes.
No, 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 no. Kick out!
Yes!
Kick out! Kick!
Yes! And Lacey Adams. Wait, wait, where are you going? Over here, you. Stop! Get back up here! Leave the popcorn vendor alone! Well, my partner just calmed down. This is Josh Stepson here for DCA. When is Wildcats episode one?
Let's see.
Yeah, my partner doesn't have a heart attack. Good night, everybody!